Ms. Malaysia, what do you want to say to me before I decide what to do with you?
I just want to acknowledge that I made some bad mistakes in the past few months, and that I regret everything that I did. I didn't think about the consequences at the time, and I want to apologize to my son with all my heart and my daughter. There's nothing I can do that will make up for anything that I did, and I'm truly sorry for it. And I'll never, you know, do anything like that ever again. I love my kids with everything they were, like my whole heart, everything. And I just want to apologize to them and to apologize to you.
Well, I certainly can't imagine the position of either you or your son, and I suppose I have to thank God for that. We have a son that doesn't want anything to do with you. And from what he has to say to me, it's for awfully good reason. I mean, you may think that this is out of line, I really don't care, but I'm a dog. He's 9 months old. He's a boxer, he's kind of big, strong. But he's a puppy. He doesn't know what I know, doesn't know what my wife knows, but he drives us crazy most of the time because he's full of youth. And he's hard to control sometimes. He's always a challenge. But what you did to this little boy, I wouldn't do to my dog. You tell me you love this little boy, and I don't have to believe you. That's not love, what was going on here. It causes me to wonder if you don't need some sort of professional help, because I can't even begin to imagine someone doing something like this to a child. I guess I agree with the state in the respect that you need to be punished. That's part of what I'm supposed to do. I have to punish the offender and protect the public from future crime by this offender and others. I'm to impose a sanction that they got to read this because not my words, but the words of the legislature. I'm to use the minimum sanctions that accomplish the purposes of sentencing without imposing an unnecessary burden on state or local government resources. I'm to consider the need for incapacitation, deterrence, rehabilitation, and restitution. The sentence is to be commensurate with and not demeaning to the seriousness of your conduct. Its impact on the victim, it must be consistent with sentences for similar crimes by similar offenders. It is not to be based on your race, ethnicity, gender, or religion. I also have to consider the seriousness and the recidivism factors. The statutory recidivism factors speak in your favor. Recidivism is unlikely in your case. I gotta tell you, I seldom sit here with a criminal defendant in front of me and can say that. That's the law. It says that recidivism is unlikely in your case. So I agree with your lawyer, something that not gonna happen again. Certainly if I don't allow any contact with him, it's not gonna happen again, so I can do something about that. The seriousness factors, however, speak strongly against you because of the physical and mental condition and age of the victim. The victim was a minor, and obviously your relationship with the victim facilitated the offense. It was your own son. Is half of my pride and joy. My other son is the other half. We were out one night and he was very young. He wouldn't listen to me. And my in-laws were there. My father-in-law was very strict and was very annoyed at the fact that I couldn't control this little boy. And I told him that I'm going to have to spank him. It didn't matter to him, but I made him that promise, and when I got home, I did spank him one time. I hit him, and I talked to him about it probably 6 months ago, about how bad I felt about that when I did it, and how bad I felt about it ever since, and that would be like 35 years ago. And I never, ever, ever did anything like that again. And what I did wasn't that bad. It was something I had to do as a parent. I can't imagine somebody doing what you did. I can't imagine a parent, someone responsible for the well-being of a child, to do something like this. No matter how frustrated you were, no matter how difficult it was, as I recall, in the discussion of this plea agreement, there was a report from the two of you that this was a challenge between the two of them. And it evidently grew to such a proportion that you couldn't control the situation. So my only decision is just where to put you. I'm going to put you in jail. With all things taken into consideration, the court's going to order that you be taken from here to the Mahoney County Justice Center and from there to the Department of Rehabilitation and Correction, there to serve a term of 9 months and to pay the costs of prosecution. While you're in the penitentiary, you're not to ingest or be injected with any drugs of abuse. You're to submit to any testing requested by the department. Those tests are to indicate that you did not ingest, nor were you injected with any drugs of abuse. Upon your release from the penitentiary, you may be ordered to serve an additional term of up to 3 years of post-release control, subject to the rules of the Adult Parole Authority and all laws. If you violate the rules, they could change the rules or increase the time you're under supervision, or they could take you back to the penitentiary for 4.5 more months. If you violate the law while on post-release control, you're going to be prosecuted and punished for the new crime. In addition to that, you're going to be taken back to the penitentiary on this crime yet again, and then made to serve the greater of whatever is left on the 3-year period of supervision for 1 year. That sentence has to be served consecutively to any sentence imposed for a new felony.